You want to go first, Jeba?
Okay, you beat me too. I was going to put you on the spot, but okay. Yeah, I'll go first. So my name is Jeba Sania. My mom and my dad, they immigrated from Bangladesh in the 90s. So I have deep roots to that country. I was born in LA. And when I was 6 years old or 7 years old, we moved to Arizona, Phoenix. So I've always been like a West Coast native, very proud of that side of the country. I'm a senior. I major in 6-2, which is electrical engineering and computer science, and I minor in brain cog science. So I'm really passionate about using technology to create social impact. So that has always kind of guided my MIT experience.
My name is Afeefah Khazi-Syed. My parents, again, also actually immigrated from India in the 90s. So I was born and raised in Arlington, Texas. At MIT, I kind of came in knowing that I wanted to do biological engineering. I was really interested in engineering, but also medicine. The plan is to go to medical school. And so B seemed like the natural like middle ground of like, oh, maybe I can do both. And this is something that me and Jeba talk about a lot, is like how all of our ancestors before us like pushed the boundary a little bit more. And I think we were so fortunate that we have this opportunity.
I'm president of a club called CASE, and we advocate for first-gen low-income students on campus. And I'm a camp KESM counselor. Additionally, I'm really involved in the Muslim Student Association. I used to be an exec member, and now I'm just like an active community member.
I also used to be an exec member, and also I'm now just an active community member. But I remember when I first came to MIT during CPW, the MSA was like one of the first groups that I met, and just the sense of community that they had, it really resonated with me. And I think there's a lot of communities like that at MIT. And that's something that we really saw when we all had to move off campus due to COVID-19. The way that we all mobilized to come support each other. I'm so grateful that of all the places I could have been when it felt like the world was falling apart, I was at MIT.
As a senior, I look back and I just think about like the person I've become has grown so much, and I'm so proud of all the experiences and all the people I got to meet. And so when this pandemic happened and everybody was forced to go home, it was really, really hard to kind of accept the fact that maybe this would be the last time I would be seeing you.
But it's been really powerful to see how people have been coming together. A lot of my professors have individually reached out to see how I'm doing. We have Zoom parties and we like catch up on each other. And it's also just like really interesting because a lot of people that reach out to me or that I reach out to are people that I haven't talked to in a while as well. And so just to see that the MIT network doesn't just belong in that small like little bubble in Cambridge, but it really is expanding like worldwide right now, I think is really cool to see.
I've always believed that STEM is kind of like the closest thing that human powers have to superpowers. I messed up. The closest things we have to superpowers, right? And so by being sent home, it's kind of like we are doing our part to save the world. And I knew that this is what I was going to have to do with my MIT education after, but it's kind of like, I guess I'm doing that right now. So it's kind of like a sacrifice we're willing to make. It's like, yeah, I could save the world from my living room.